This thing was called a wake load, Jordan.
That's right. And it all started 10 p.m. Wednesday night. Sort of the ingredients were starting to develop. And you can see this big shield of rain moving through Louisiana and Mississippi and eventually working its way into Alabama. Not too terribly severe, if anything at all. But then as the rain started to end, this is 4:25 in the morning, around 4:30, while you were still asleep, we started to see a surface high develop on the backside of all the rain. And this is caused by the rain cooled air at the surface. So we start to see that sinking motion. And then back on the other side of this surface high, we start to see what we call this wake low develop on the other side of the high. And this is caused more by that gentle sinking warmer air further aloft. And how these two systems work together is what caused some pretty strong wind gusts earlier this morning. Higher pressure tends to sink a whole lot faster and quicker than, in this case, this lower pressure, and it caused a pretty vast pressure gradient. Pressure gradient is the winds themselves. So spots like Tuscaloosa County, Jefferson, Cullman, up to Oneonta, and Blount County, Bibb County, saw some pretty strong wind gusts earlier this morning. You can see that, and we saw that on some of the maps earlier, from Tuscaloosa to Cullman, Gadsden saw a few wind gusts down towards northern Chilton, Bibb, southern Shelby, all the way through Talladega and Calhoun counties too. Here are some of the max wind gusts we saw this morning. 25 mile per hour winds here in Birmingham, 30 in Cullman Regional, 27 in Winfield, 44 in Tuscaloosa, 45 down there in Alabaster. And the point here to make is that these wake loads are very hard to forecast. And while this isn't too terribly severe, we've seen wake loads in the past all across the country create and generate wind gusts up to 40, 50, 60, sometimes 70 miles per hour. So it's always best to stay up to date with the latest forecast.
Well, hurricane season is less